What's up guys, this is Balazs from Racing Brick. I received tons of comments on my latest video about the 3.1 version of the Powered Up app, so I decided to create another one, focusing on the power functions control. If you did not see the first video, then you can watch it by clicking on the link in the top right corner. So, apart from the obvious challenges of the control approach chosen by the developers, I wanted to see how the app control compares to the good old infrared remote control. And I also wanted to check if there are any other potential possibilities to achieve a similar result. The first comparison is reaction time. During the filming of the previous video, I noticed some lag when I tried to control the power functions motors with the Powered Up app, so I created this simple setup. I have two infrared receivers, one for the infrared remote and one for the Powered Up color and distance sensor, set to a different channel. As you can see here, if the code is kept at the bare minimum and the sensor is close enough to the receiver, then there's no significant lag. The response does not feel as snappy as with the infrared remote, but still okay-ish. Now let's try another setup which is more useful. Here's a code that uses the Powered Up remote to have a similar setup like the Power Functions remote. The setup works most of the time, but again, it is not as responsive as the original remote. The motor starts a bit later, and it also runs a bit longer when the button is not pressed anymore. The code runs as a series of if-else loops, so that might have an effect on the processing time. Here's a different setup. It uses the start on condition block to trigger the infrared codes based on the buttons pressed on the remote. Theoretically, this one should run quicker, but I did not see too much improvement. And on the other hand, this setup has a tendency to get stuck in a state and the motor keeps running. It does not handle well either the short presses or the quick direction changes. The previous tests were replicating the simple bang-bang control of the infrared remote, and the good old physical remote seems to be the winner so far. But what about the benefits and advanced controls of the Powered Up system? With this setup, it is possible to create a code with proportional speed control. Unfortunately, it is not so simple to set up, and as you can see, the response time and the speed changes are not great either. The system sort of works, but I would not recommend it for a car control or something similar. As an alternative, we have the Brick Controller 2 app, which can also control power functions through the infrared receiver if the phone has a built-in IR port. Mine has one, so as you can see, it works pretty well with the game controller. The proportional speed control works better, and the response time is also good. Probably still not as quick as the infrared remote, but still feels manageable. By the way, if you don't know the Brick Controller 2 app, I highly recommend to check it out. You can find detailed videos about it on my channel. You can use it to control power functions through the infrared receiver, S-Brick, boobies, Powered Up, all from a single app, and it is very straightforward to use. I can show you quickly how easy it is to set up a control profile. Just compare it with the amount of code needed for the same thing in the Powered Up app. You start with a new creation, just give it any name you prefer. The creation will have a control profile by default. You can use that one now. Press the plus button in the top right corner to add the new controller. Then trigger that controller on the gamepad. Once it is detected, you can assign a device to it and then set the parameters if needed. You can select the outputs, invert the channel if needed, and then set up some advanced settings. That's pretty much it. Now let's see a distance test. The infrared remote works pretty well indoors. Here's a little setup I created with the receivers attached to the motors in one corner of the room. I will test the infrared remote, the Powered Up sensor and my phone as well, and measure the distance where it is still working okay. As you can see, I can't really go far enough to lose control. The remote works most of the time, even if I don't point it directly to the receiver. So it's powerful enough to control stuff indoors at a reasonable distance. Here's a quick measurement. The distance of the receiver is around 6 meters and it was still working perfectly fine. I think it would also work from further, but that's as far as I can go in here. Now let's see the performance of the powered up color and distance sensor. It seems to have issues already at this short distance, so I will need to get closer. This is where it starts to work well. Let's see how far we are. It's only 2 meters at this time. This is significantly less than the distance with the power function remote. Here's another difference. I need to point the sensor exactly to the receiver, otherwise it does not work. The remote signal was strong enough to be reflected from the walls or the ceiling and it still worked, but this sensor seems to be much weaker. Apparently my phone's IR blaster is similarly weak. Not sure if there are other models with a stronger one. It does not seem to be very usable for this purpose. So after the stationary target, let's see something that moves. I used the slightly modified B model of the 4209 remote control stunt racer for this purpose. That was the last model released by LEGO that uses the infrared remote. The control with the remote is easy and straightforward. The response from the motors is quick enough to control the racer easily. Now let's see the same with the powered up remote. The code is similar to the one used previously. I duplicated it to have both channels available. I needed to attach the remote to the hub and the sensor to be able to aim with it properly. As you can see, since the sensor is much weaker than the infrared remote, it is actually quite difficult to find the angle where the signals are successfully transmitted. The control itself is also laggy, the command stuck sometimes, and the motor keeps running. This method of controlling the powered functions motors with the sensor remotely might be nice as a proof of concept on stationary models, but in real-life applications like this one, it simply fails. Now let's try something else. As the sensor works only at a short distance, what if we put the powered up hub and the sensor right next to the power functions infrared receiver? This is not really an economical solution, since we could simply replace the power functions motors with powered up ones, but let's assume that there are scenarios where this might still be a reasonable choice. So, in this case we are not limited by the infrared range of the sensor, we also have the benefit of the Bluetooth range for the remote. The reaction time is still a bit worse than with the original IR remote, but it is sort of playable. The stunt racer was only used for demonstration, but I wanted to find quickly something that could justify the usage of the powered up and power function systems together. So let's assume we would like to add a blinking light to our model. That is something that you could not do with the power functions infrared system alone. I added a simple code to make the attached light blink, and I used the powered up remote to control the car. Again, it's only a simple demonstration. I'm sure you can come up with scenarios where this might be actually useful. In this case, honestly, it's a better choice to use the original infrared remote and leave only the blinking part to the powered up hub. So, to sum up my experience, the power functions infrared control through the powered up color and distance sensor is a nice tech demo, but I found very little practical use for it. In most of the cases, it is still better to use the original infrared controller and add some extra programmed features with the powered up components if needed. I can imagine some scenarios, for example a train system, where it can be practical, but all my train sets are in a warehouse now, so I cannot test it. Please let me know in the comments if you did some successful tests or you have some ideas where this mixed powered up power functions control can be actually useful and practical. I think the best solution is still Brick Controller 2 for most of the cases. Here's a little demo for you. With a single setup, I can control S-Brick, Goobies and Powered Up. I have proportional speed control for the motors. I can configure an on-off toggle button for light, for example. I can have buttons that work only when pressed. And now there's even an option to create simple sequences in the app, so you can use it for lights and other stuff. This app can be used in most of the scenarios, and if you still need advanced programming for power functions, then you can always use S-Brick with Scratch. If you like this video, then please give it a thumbs up. You can also subscribe and tap the notification bell if you want to see more tech reviews and other LEGO RC videos. See you next time. Bye bye.